Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Lizzy Love Kitchen TV. On today's recipe, guys, I will be showing you how I prepare my egusi soup with spinach, chicken, cow meat, and crayfish. So guys, in this egusi, you can use it to eat eba, fufu, amala, any kind of swallow that you like. You can use it egusi to eat the swallow. So guys, stay tuned and let's get started how I prepare this egusi soup. Guys, these are my ingredients for the egusi soup. So we are going to be using this mackerel fish, onions, hot burning pepper, tomatoes, crayfish, two seasoning, salt, chicken, stock fish, egusi seeds that we are going to use, and cow meat. We are going to be using spinach and red oil. So guys, stay tuned and keep on watching this video, how it ended, how I make this egusi soup recipe. Stay tuned guys as we proceed. So guys, now we are going to be cooking our meat. I just pour the meat inside the pot. I'll be adding some salt to taste, one seasoning cube, chopped onions, and I will stir together and leave it to cook for some minutes before I add my warm water. Cover it to cook for some minutes before adding warm water. So guys, this is after some minutes of cooking the meat. I will just stir it and add my warm water to the meat. This is after cooking the meat for some minutes without water. Now I will be adding my water to cook the meat for like 15 minutes or more, depend on how you like your meat to be tender and soft. For me, I like my meat very soft, so I will be cooking in for 15 to 20 minutes. So let's leave the meat to cook guys. So guys, this is after some minutes. Now I will be adding my stock fish because I want it to be very soft. That is why I just add the stock fish to cook with the meat. So let's leave it to cook for some minutes. I will also add my mackerel fish because I will be removing the mackerel fish so that you not get pieces. Let's color it to cook. Now we are going to be blending our egusi seed, crayfish, and onions, and the peppers, and everything. All the ingredients will be blended together. I will blend the egusi seed separate and blend the peppers and the onions separate, guys. So stay tuned and keep watching. So guys, this is all my ingredients that I'm going to be blend: pepper, onions, tomatoes, and crayfish, and scotch bonnet pepper. So guys, stay tuned and keep watching. I will blend everything together to make the egusi soup. So guys, this is after pouring the red oil on the pot. So I will be frying my blended tomatoes and onions. As you can see, I've already blend it off camera, and this is my blended egusi soup, blended egusi seed. I will be adding this chopped onion to it and stir together. I will stir it very well. So now I have to add my blended tomatoes and onions I'll be pouring it inside the pot now. So by this is after pouring the blended tomatoes and the onions and pepper together, I will just leave it to cook for some minutes before adding the blended egusi seed. Meanwhile, I have already boiled my meat. I have also fried some. So guys, stay tuned and see the end of this egusi recipe. So guys, this is after frying the blended pepper for a while. I just come to check on it. I will still leave it to fry for some minutes before I add my blended egusi seed. So guys, let's check on our stew to make the egusi soup. Now the stew is ready. Let's stir it and see if we can add the egusi now. All the water have dried off from the tomatoes and onions. So now we are going to be adding our egusi seed, our blended egusi seed, step by step, just like this. I blended my egusi with water. You can also blend the egusi with a dry blended blender. So this is it guys, stay tuned and keep on watching. I will be cutting the egusi little by little like this until it gets finished, then I cover it to cook. So guys, after I have cut all the egusi, I will just stir it a little bit and leave it to cook. I will be covering it now. Guys, let's check on our egusi. Wow. Now we are going to be adding our spinach because I will be using spinach for the egusi soup. Now we have to stir. So guys, this is after stirring it. I will be adding my stock meat water and the stock fish. I will also stir it and cover it to cook. Guys, let's check on our egusi soup. Wow, we are going to be turning it. After stirring it, we'll be adding our fried meat now. If you like, you can also cook it with your boiled meat. But for me, sometimes I like to fry my meat to cook my soup. I will be stirring it very well off camera. So guys, at this point, we are going to be adding our macrophage. And stir a little bit. And we'll also be covering it again to cook for some minutes when it's done. Egusi soup is very very easy to prepare guys. So guys, we are going to be checking on our egusi. It's ready. Let's turn it and see the outcome of it. Wow, this egusi is so delicious guys. Thank you for watching. I will be placing the egusi in a bowl now. So I've finished preparing it. Thank you for watching. God bless you all for staying with me how I prepared my egusi soup. So guys, if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, Lazy Love Kitchen TV, subscribe guys and place your comment in the comment section below if you find this video helpful. So give this video a thumbs up and press the notification bell. Whenever I upload a video, you will be the first to notify. Thank you all for joining me how I prepare my egusi soup. God bless you all. Until I come your way again, see you next time. Bye.